Filipino, and we will give a topic about love and courtship. And for continuation, for preparation for the our banquet this coming January 15th. So Pastor Brian is district pastor from Bulacan and our host from Hope Channel.
Good morning to everyone.
Morning.
I will go back to the points I wanted to make. This is sort of a counsel for those who wanted to really become pastors. Not many become successful in pastoral ministry. Statistics-wise, there are many who graduate in the college, but not many survive in the field. Even if they survive, there are still many issues that involves in being a successful pastor. And I think all of us wanted to become really a successful pastor. But there are hindrances to this result. And I think I want to battle against some hindrance that might encounter in the journey to the pastoral world. Amen? The college is but a mere representation of what is going to happen in the field. In the battlefield, it's totally different. Okay, it's totally different. First, I want to tap the idea that it's almost impossible to be in. Mali po yung idea na imposible main. So, maraming nag-discourage. Ayaw na nang pumunta sa field because they think it's almost a journey of a little journey to become to be a pastor. I don't think so. If you are persistent, you make all opposing circumstances your helpers, not your hindrance. Okay? But we need to be aware that there are things that really destroy resolve. There are things that destroy resolve. I think I will be discussing sexuality in PYC, but I will not discuss it today. Pero there are such things na talagang nagpapabagsak. Dito pa lang sa university, papabagsakin ka na. Hindi ka na makakarating doon sa field. So, even if you go to the field, if you're still, if your resolve is destroyed, and there is still a big difficulty. In fact, kahit na nasa field ka na, kahit may asawa ka na, this is still an issue that we need to really resolve. So let me start biblically. In Genesis chapter 1 verse 26, God said, "Let us make man in our own image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth." Let me focus on the word, "Let us make man in our own image." Originally, the image of God is the purpose of its creation. So, because this image was destroyed by sin, our first objective in our education here in the campus is to bring back this image, original image of God in us. It is not marriage that we should be thinking about while we are studying in the university. It's not about relationship, it's not about sweetheart relationship that we must be first thinking in this university, though it goes along afterwards. Siguro, kung talagang gusto natin maging successful, if we want to be successful, we must always think of the original purpose of God. To let us make man in our own image. The making of God in our own image. So our first journey to a pastoral world is a journey of spiritual growth. In this university, do not hinder your spiritual growth by taking another person who is also in the journey of spiritual growth and thinking that you can help the person and the person can help you. I don't think so. If you are not whole, if she is not whole, you'll just destroy each other. Second, so God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, I fully believe that man cannot be fully whole . There's a great contribution on a lady, I mean a woman, in the making whole of man. Because God said, it is not good for a man to be alone. But it is not also good for a man not to be a man. We must first be a man. Before we think of a woman, before we make ourselves whole. The Bible says in Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 13, this is the conclusion of all matters. Fear God and keep His commandment, because this is the whole man. So, duty, the word duty was only supplied, it was not there. The whole man. In Ecclesiastes chapter 3, I think it was barely discussed in chapter 2. That man and beast has no difference. They go to the same dust. They have the same breath of life. So when you die, you die like a beast. The only difference is when you keep the commandments of God and you fear God and you have the image of God, then you are man. But many of those who courted a lady are not yet man. Come on. Not yet man. When I was a child, I think as a child, I speak as a child. But when I become a man, I do a great childish things. But why are these foolish things still done by theology students and they think that they're already a man, courting a lady? And yung parents ng lady may daladalang panyo sa friend, yung tanong mo, pakamanggata sa lady. Sigurado ako, maliligaw ka na. May dumating daw kay Pastor Ovi before. 12 years old, that's 14 years old. Pastor, may papaalam po ako. Sigurado ka iyo. Usap nga po namin ng parents mo. We must always think that before we court a lady, before we think of marriage fulfillment, we must first think of our spiritual growth. We must become a man. We must be formed in the image of God. The perfection of Christ in us must be seen before. Alam mo yung kalahati ka palang naghahanap ka ng isa pang kalahati. Ang mapuproduce mong anak, kalahati din. Okay? Second, and God blessed them and said to them, be fruitful. Be fruitful. We must always consider that before we get married, or at least think of getting married or having a relationship with a lady, we must ask ourselves, are we already fruitful? Wala ka pang nakukontribute sa society, gusto mo na mag-asawa, o di magpuproduce ka lang ng isang tao na wala rin contribution sa buong mundo. Did you get the point? So we must always think, are we already fruitful? Have we done enough? I mean, kulang ka pa nga sa sarili mo, magdadamay ka pa ng isa, ma. Napakahirap naman. Saan mo dadalhin? Asawa ko, may naliligaw sa kanyang nurse, walang trabaho. Saan naliligaw ka sa akin, wala kang trabaho? Saan mo ko dadalhin? Magtatambay tayong dalawa. Do you get the point? So the point here is, you must have your own direction. You must know where you're going. Because when you don't know where you're going, where are you carrying the lady to? I mean, where are you going, the both of you? So if the blind cannot lead another blind. So first, be fruitful. I always say, be fruitful. When you have practically mastered your career, it would be well for you, if you already mastered your career, to get married. Why? Because you must clone yourself so that one could again be produced, so that it could be productive and fruitful to benefit the whole earth. Amen? Ang problema sa mga, eto sasabihin ko sa inyo, medyo tapatan na tayo. Pre-intern pa lang nag-asawa na. Nung nag-asawa, kulang financially. So, when they were just pre-intern, they got married because they were very excited, experimenting on all of this. Well, they were very excited. Then one day were just pre-intern, they got married, and when they have troubles in money, of course the parents-in-law are already talking, and you don't have any choice but to go to a job that gives money to support the family. You have to think it practically. This is not just about theology, faith, and all of this. I think we need to be very practical. Because those who survive in the ministries are those who really think. Think ahead. And I think when you graduate, it's already late. After graduation, you know all of this is already late. We must orient our young people earlier than that. Kasi kung dito pa lang, naliligaw-ligaw na kayo, and it would take about 8 years bago kayo magpakasal, pag na-regular kayo, I don't think you can keep yourself 8 years na walang nangyayaring sexual immoralities. Or siguro magsasawaan nyo na yung isa't isa. Then you are just breaking a heart, di ba? Kung magsasawa din kayo at maghihiwalay din kayo, ba't pa kayo magsisweetheart? Pag tinatanong ko, ba't pa kayo magsisweetheart? Hindi makasagot bakit. Maybe because Hollywood movies has already instructed us to do so. But Hollywood movies is not principle. So let first be fruitful. When you have become already fruitful, pagka gamay mo na ang distrito mo, you already know the ins and outs of your career. Then you can master your family. Amen?
Amen.
Don't master family and career at the same time. Don't master family. You despise the other and you'll be loyal to other. Am I right? You despise the other and loyal to others. I say practically, but this is just ideology. This is not... There are many, many situations that does not qualify with what I'm talking about. But at least for general, in general, to be very practically, to practically survive in the field, and I'm talking about the field, time in the field, you have to think of it right now. Be fruitful. Be fruitful. So, when you go there, the first question the executive secretary, at least the ministerial secretary, would always ask you is, please, don't get married before regularship. This is the first question always asked by Pastor Cabeña, or either Pastor Noel Galang, or Pastor Kahobi, the three ministerial secretary. They always, pakiusap, can you get married? Just after regulation. Because there are great tendency that the world, your practical finances, would not work out if you want to be very successful. I'm just practically telling you what is happening, really practically in the field. Second, be fruitful and then multiply. When you have become already fruitful, then it is apparent that you have to multiply. Then, because you need to multiply, then you need to have another, a wife to multiply. You cannot multiply without a wife. You can multiply without a wife, maybe by discipleship. But of course, you wanted to have your own, amen? Multiply. And then, replenish or subdue the earth. Subdue the earth. Replenish and then subdue the earth. And have dominion, stewardship, dominion. Government. Maybe a work to do to govern. Because this is the way na ginagawa ng Panginoon in order for us to be occupied. To be occupied. And then, don't worry about food. After that, Genesis 1:29 says, behold, I have given you every herb. When you are in the field, don't worry about food. Or drink, or about clothes for your body. Is it life worth more than food or drink? Or your body worth more than clothes? Look at the birds flying in the sky. They do not plant or harvest. Yet your loving Father in heaven takes good care of them. My salary. My salary survives for about 3 or 4 days. After that, you really have to find where are you to find the salary after. I mean, food. It's always like that. I tell you, wala trabaho masawa ko because she decided to really concentrate on my sons and daughters. Pero kung walang trabaho masawa niya, it would really be a struggle even if you are already ordained. But we have never doubted that God is going to give us His food, Nung last time, nung ako sabi ko, wala na akong sapatos. Nag-pray kami for sapatos ng mga kapatid. Within just 2 months, bumumos po yung sapatos. Ngayon parang mga 7-8 na sapatos ko. Sabi ko, ano magagamitin ko? Sabi ko kay Christian, Christian halika ka. Sabi ko, tingnan mo may paa mo. Sabi ko, pumunta ka din, may sapatos na naman to. And I was just praying about kasi isang sapatos na the whole year. But I tell you, God is going to provide. Don't worry about it. What you worry about is your work, then your family, and what family will be very much a priority. So there are three major, very important decisions that you need to really settle: spiritual growth, second is career stability, third is marriage fulfillment. Pagka gamay mo na ano mo, distrito mo, yep, distrito ko pa. Concentrate with your wife, concentrate with your son, your daughter, because you already a master of your own career. Amen? Hindi yung minamaster mo yung career mo, napabaya mo, minamaster mo yung family mo, at the same time, wala kang naging benefit. Amen. This is, tinitignan ko yung mga printer ngayon, nakikita ko, hirap na hirap talaga sila, because they are trying to do two things at the same time. Yung studies nila dito, at saka yung sweetheart, the both of it, are not conduit to each other, unless siguro, kung siguro graduating na whatever, maybe you can think about it. Kasi mahirap na rin humanap pag nasa field na, di ba? Mahirap na rin. Actually, madali. They are the quality that you would really want it. Medyo kailan, ano ka na lang, magtsatsaga ka na lang kung ano yung mahalan. Okay, now let's go to Songs of Solomon, chapter 2, verse 7, 3, verse 5, 8, verse 4, the same word. I charge you, O daughters of Jerusalem, by the rose and by the hands of the field, that ye stir up not or awake love until he pleases, until he so desires. We must be aware that we must not arouse or awaken love until it so desires. In the translation, it says, until it is the right time. Until it is the right time. Huwag niyo mga kapatid, ititikil yung love. Siguro, tingnan ko nga ito kung may love. No. Do not arouse or awaken love until it so desires. The right, I think the interpretation of that, until it so desires, or it he pleases, is until it is the right time. Until it is the right time. Because love is not a feeling, it's a principle. They say love is a feeling when you're about to feel, don't you feel the feeling that you felt before? It's just curiosity, okay? You don't base your action upon your feelings, because feelings, we call it emotional reasoning. I do this for something, I feel it. I go to church because I feel it, and I don't go to church when I don't. So I don't think feelings is it can be trusted. Our feelings cannot always be trusted. So we counsel with people who have no feeling, di ba? We counsel with people, kasi they are not, hindi naman sila in love, di ba? So, pag tinanong natin sila practically, they will tell you, you're foolish. You know, foolishness is in the heart of a child. When you're a child and you're immature, you're always foolish. And your decisions are always foolishness. So when you're immature, don't get engaged in this relationship. Because the moment you get in this relationship, you'll only find another immature person. Eh, pastor, baka maunahan ako. Naliligaw. Ang naliligaw ang lalaki sa babae kasi baka maunahan. Ang babae naman kaya nagpapaligaw, baka maubusan. I don't think that's a very excellent idea. What is love? Love, in Adventist, Acts of the Apostles 551, this love is not impulse, but a divine principle. A permanent power. Amen? Love is a principle, it is a permanent power. The unconsecrated heart cannot originate or produce it. Hindi ka nga makapagtagumpay pa sa sarili mo. Hindi ka makapagtagumpay sa sexual desires mo. Hindi ka makapagtagumpay. You have not overcome your lust. Now you think that you can love. A person who lusts cannot love. Because a person who lusts thinks only about himself, not the interest of others. You give love in order to gain sex. Ganun lang yung ginagawa ng lustful na tao. And women gave sex in order to gain love. And this is not a good transaction. not a good transaction. Gamitan, ang tawag ulit yung gamitan. Not thinking about the interest of others. In Philippians chapter 2, verse 3 and 4. You have to think about the interest of others. You must esteem others better than yourself. You must not provide for yourself, your own lust. You must always think that love is a principle. We love Him because He first loved us. In the heart, renewed by the divine grace, love is the ruling principle of action. So yeah, love is a principle. It doesn't make sense to me. Whenever Mrs. White says love is a principle, it doesn't make sense to me. Love is a principle. Principle what? When I found out that one of her writings says, love is the ruling principle of action. Now it makes sense. Because the actions you made were ruled by the so-called love. And if love is infatuation, then you ruin your own action. Well, actions are always ruined by wrong, by infatuations. Proverbs chapter 4 verse 23 says, keep thy heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life, are the wellspring of life. Guard your heart. The word guard was an emphatic word. In fact, the literal translation should be guard your heart. Ang ginawa na lang nila, guard your heart with all diligence. With all diligence. And how do you guard your heart with all diligence? Of course, you have to guard your eyes. In Job chapter 31 verse 1 says, I have covenanted with my eyes that I may not look at a lady with a lust. Because where your eyes go, your heart also. Amen? In verse 5. So guard your eyes in order to guard your heart. Paano mo i-guard yung heart mo kung nanonood ka ng pornography, ng ganito ka, ganyan-ganyan? There was a Baptist ministerial camp when they went to a hotel. I think it was a resort. And there was internet in the resort. And for the history of that hotel, never did they notice in the history of their hotel that 80% of all those who browse in the internet watch pornography. And these are all ministers. And there are 2,000 cases among bishops and priests now of sexual immoralities. And one of the bishops in America cost the church $2 billion paid. Nag-pay sila ng $2 billion, the church, the Catholic Church, paid for, dahil sa isang, I think, pedophilia. So it's creeping within all ministerial lines, the unethical issues of sex. Why? Because we do not guard our heart. So keep your heart with all diligence. Kasi saan daw bumabagsak usually ang pastor? Kwarto. O kwarta. But I don't think babagsak ito if we are very aware that we need to really guard our heart. Proverbs chapter 3 verse 5 says, trust in the Lord with all your heart. When I say with all your heart, do not trust your heart. When you trust in the Lord with all your heart, never trust yourself. It says, lean not unto your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct your path. And He says, be not wise in your own eyes, and shun, fear the Lord, and shun evil. We cannot play with relationships, especially as a pastor. We cannot play with relationships, especially as a pastor. In our integrity lies the power to preach. Amen? If you don't have the integrity, especially for yourself and for your sweetheart, then your capacity to preach and the power to influence the unction of the Holy Spirit is hindered because of their lack of integrity. Of your lack of integrity. Samson failed. Solomon failed. And these are the strongest and the wisest person on earth. And I think they are the weakest and the most foolish person ever recorded in the Bible. They failed with women. Tama ba? They failed with women. And these are the ministers of the Old Testament. They failed with women. Why? Because they were overconfident of themselves. We must guard our heart with all diligence in order to become successful. or to become successful. I'm not saying you need to be really, really perfect, but I say that we must do our best because we are God's servants, the servants of the Lord. Amen? The servants of the Lord. I think the 144 is called the servants of the Lord. Amen? In Revelation chapter 17. So, the servants of the Lord. Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 9. The heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who shall know? Okay, let me give a little background of what should be the foundation of every relationship. Before you consider, of course, marriage, we have to think that the foundation of marriage is pyramidal. First foundation of a good marriage is communication. So, of course, when you build communication out of trust, and then trust begets commitment, and then commitment, we have the marriage privilege called sex. Sex can never be eliminated. It is the pleasure God given as a privilege of marriage. To become one. You are the flesh of my flesh, the bone of my bones. Amen? Your desire shall be of your husband. Sabi ba? Your desire shall be of your husband. So women must desire what their husband desire. The happiness of the husband becomes the happiness of wife. When it is not perverted. Now, many relationships are built with sex. In the world, they are built with sex. So when a woman says, when the mother says, why don't you, you have to cut out with your sex activity and say, then my sweetheart is going to leave me if I cut it out. Then you ask the question. So if you cut the sex, you cut the relationship. So what ties the both of you? What ties the both of you? So many fear that they would lose the relationship when they lose the sex because the only foundation of the relationship was sex, desire, their connection with each other. Are just what? Very temporal. Very fleshful. But I say that every relationship must be built in good communication. I'll tell you about a little bit about communication. Must be built on communication. Good communication builds trust. And trust builds commitment. You destroy communication, you destroy trust, you destroy commitment. But if you still build on sex, this is very detrimental because this is a sinking sand. This is a sinking sand. Any relationship built on an icing to the cake is not good. Would you like to build your house on a sinking sand, on an ice? I don't think so. So, I'm always telling our young people to build their family of good communication. Dito lagi nag-aaway namin. I have been counseling people. I have seen mga naghihiwalay na mag-asawa. The only boiling point is always communication. Destroy communication, you destroy the family. But how many young people are skilled in communicating? Especially James chapter 1 verse 19. Be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to become angry. Quick to listen, I don't think many are skilled in listening. Kahit pag sweetheart kayo, you don't almost listen, you always talk. Diba? So I think if we have not come to this skill of communication, then we are not appropriated to have any relationship. In fact, even with your brother, your sister, your mother, your father, if you don't have good communication, then there is no trust, there is no commitment. And more so, there is no sensible fellowship, whatever it is. Of course, this is a marriage privilege, but yung kinesthetic, may nagsalita. It is a Hindu, I think I saw it on Facebook, it was a Hindu saint who asked the question, ba't ba nagsisigawan yung naglalabang ng asawa? Why are they shouting with each other? And then the Hindu, the disciples said, because of this, because of that. Then the Hindu saints said, they were shouting with each other because their hearts are far from each other. They cannot hear each other because their hearts are far. So when husbands and wives quarrel and then shout at the top of their voice, then it means their hearts are good. But when they are united, build and commune to each other, they almost don't talk. They just don't sense each other's mind. But you cannot always read one's mind. When you have been acquainted to a person, at least for 5 years, the tendency, you will only read his mind about 25%. But if you are married for 30 years, the tendency is you can read his, her mind for 85%. Still, 25% failure. You cannot read mind, so you really have to speak it out. Amen? But the first skill must be listening. You have to listen. The ability to listen solves almost all problems in all the earth. Amen? The ability to listen solves all the problems. I think St. Francis of Assisi said to be understood, to understand rather than to be understood. To love rather to be loved. Diba? So I think it solves the problem. So before you go to relationship, you must have a good communication. First, communicate with your parents, communicate with your brothers and sisters, communicate with your friends. Practice communication before any relationship. If you don't have a good communication, you don't have a good relationship with your father, your mother, your brother, your pastor, or whatever, and you're having a conflict with another, then you will have a conflict with your wife or your sweetheart in the future. You have to really master the skill of listening. Then also master the skill of speaking. Speak it out from your heart. You have to listen with your heart and not with your ears. You have to talk with your heart and not with your ears. And not many. Pag galit na sa yung tao, you don't anymore process what is in his mind. You only process what was said in her mouth. Not what was the real felt need of the person. So that's the problem why relationships are being destroyed. And when relationships are destroyed, pag panaghiwalay na tayo sa field, mag-asawa, sa tingin mo, pastor ka pa? Destroy the family and career will be destroyed. Build the family will be built. But destroy the career, sometimes the family also will be destroyed. So it's a choice that you have to make today. You have to really fix your choices today, make it right, seek counsel, especially with the experienced pastors that we have. Amen?
Amen.
Now, 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 4, 2 says, "For I am jealous over you with godly jealousy, for I have espoused you to one husband, that I may present you as a chaste virgin to Christ." No wonder many of our young people today do not go to church to be wed. If our ministers themselves are not chaste or doesn't have any purity anymore. So I appeal that our pastors must be the first one to maintain sexual purity. Amen? We are not perfect, my and my wife, but she is my first sweetheart. The first that I ever courted in my life, and she and I was a virgin when we got married. The integrity that we have helped us to help other young people to overcome as such the same. Amen. So I appeal. I think napakadali lang naman. So maybe the last that I want to talk about communication is this. The five levels of communication. This is taught in Master Guide, but just to give you an idea kung saan kayo dapat mag-stop kapag medyo sumusobra. The first is acquaintance. This is the level when you say, "Hi, hello, kumusta ka na, so and so, and so and so." So that is a relationship already. Problema kasi maraming mga pastor hindi rin marunong ligaw eh. Alam mo kung unang ligaw, ganito. Friend, kilala kita, nakita kita yun. Okay ka talaga. Kailangan ko ng asawa. Yes, I have heard this from many pastors. Many, and I'm talking about many. Kailangan ko ng asawa. Ngayon, kung gusto mo, tawagan mo, text mo. I think they were already very practical. These are very experienced pastors, and they don't want to talk anymore about sweetheart thing and all of this. And then, there was a time when I think it was ayoko na magpanggit. Kasi kaibigan ko eh. Di sabi ng babae, di, ato na yung babae, hindi na yung babae. After 2 years, galing Thailand, 2 to 3 years, nag-isip na yung babae, matanda na siya, sabi, mukhang kailangan ng asawa. So nag-text siya ng forwarded message, magandang message dun sa lalaki. Nag-text ka agad yung ayoko. Gusto kong mabanggit sa amin. Yung pangalan, mababanggit ko na eh. Sabi ng lalaki, o ano, ready ka na ba? Yeah. After 3 years ha, sabi niya, kung ready ka na, sabihin mo sa akin, sabi niya, punta ka na lang sa bahay. Nagpaalam ka agad dun sa ano, sa pangkakla, nagpaalam sa bahay. And then after 2 weeks, pinasal sila. And they have a good marriage. But we should not, ano, we should always respect the level of growth, amen? The friendship and all this, yes? Speak English. Okay, thank you. Sorry. I'm so sorry. I was carried away. Now, acquaintance. The high-hello level. This is already level of relationship, but on the level of acquaintance. This will grow into sharing information. So, where do you live? What is your favorite food? What do you think about this? Where are you going? And all of this are sharing information. This is another level of communication, but it is not enough. If you want to level up, you really have to do some things to really level up. Okay, and then sharing information, and then after that, sharing opinion. What do you think about this? I think this is right. I think this is wrong. And you have to respect opinion. You know, we know how to respect opinion, even if you differ with each other. The charity of love, Christian love, is to respect one's opinion. Okay? One's opinion. Even if you differ or there's variance among you, you must always be respectful as a Christian. But after you share opinion, even if you differ with each other, there is another level, the sharing of feelings. We must be very careful with this. There are levels of feelings that we need to be very careful about. When women started to confide, we are not Superman. Marami mga naging Superman dito nakabuntis. Ministerial, hindi namin ministerial. Kasi they think, oh, I'm Superman. You tell me your problem, I solve it. Yes. Meron akong ano na ano siya. She was molested by an elder, and she was trying to confide to the layman. The layman was trying to help her. And also the layman molested her as well. Because they think they're Superman. You know, pastors are almost like Superman. When lady try to confide, it's a red light already. That's already a red light. Danger zone. Sharing of feelings is another level. And if you cannot control the transfer of emotion, you cannot almost control the transfer of emotion. You should refer her to a more professional or think. A lady or somebody else, but we must always be. But this is another level. I'm talking about gutom ako, you know. When a lady comes to you for the first time hindi niyo kilala, and she said, "I'm hungry." What do you think? What would you think about her? Or I'm angry. Of course, you would. Why would you tell me that? It doesn't make sense, diba? Because that's another level. You don't talk about it when you first met, right? So this is another level. We must guard this level, and yet we must cherish this level, especially when we're getting towards friendship, relationship, or I think this is another level. But the highest level, perhaps the most intimate level, is the level of honesty or sharing honesty. Honesty sharing. This is the level of husbands and wife, when there is no reserve anymore. Everything can be spoken, everything. Naked. Amen? Naked. Why am I telling this? Because this is the level that you can take care bago kayo pumunta dito. But if you are not careful of this, this can ruin you or this can build you. Amen? You can build friendship here, evangelism here. You can build a relationship here or friendship here in this level. But you ought to be very discreet in all manners. Now, a little bit, alam ko hindi pwede discuss lang. You can maybe ask questions. A young man who enjoys the society and wins the friendship of a young lady unbeknown to her parents. Ito ethics, I want to talk about ethics because many pastors have sweethearts without even consulting the parents. And I don't think this is very ethical for a pastor. For a pastor. A young man who enjoys the society and wins the friendship of a young lady unbeknown to her parents does not act a noble Christian part toward her or toward her parents. Through secret communications, meetings, he may gain an influence over her mind, but in so doing, he fails to manifest the nobility and integrity of soul which every child of God will possess. In order to accomplish their ends, they act a part that is not frank and open and according to the Bible standard, and prove themselves untrue to those who love them and try to be faithful guardians over them. Ikaw ang guardian ne, pero ikaw mismo ang sumira ng trust. You are the must supposed to be the guardian of that lady, but you destroy resolve and integrity. So how can she really have to trust you? I mean, if I'm a lady acquainted with the Bible and Spirit of Prophecy, that kind of move is not frank. And that would be a disqualification already. In order to accomplish the ends, marriage contracted under such influences, ang dami kong pagkakamali ng mga kabataan ko in the district. And it's always my reminder, marriage contracted under such influences are not according to the Word of God. He who lead a daughter away from her duty to her parents, who would confuse her ideas of God's plain and positive commands to obey and honor the parents, is not one who would be true to the married obligation. If she is not true to that God, his obligation to the parents, he would not be true to his obligation to the wife in the future. If he lies against the parents, your parents, if I lie against your parents, I will also lie with you, to you. Thou shalt not steal, was written in the finger of God upon the tables of stone. Yet how much underhand stealing of affection is practiced and excused. Ano yung sabihin ng underhand? Pangungupit. Hindi siya sabihin natin na stealing na todo-todo, but this is pangungupit. Underhand stealing. A deceptive courtship is maintained. Private communications are kept up until the affections of the one who is inexperienced and know not whether to these things may grow are in a measure withdrawn from her parents and placed upon him. Her affections were withdrawn from her parents and given to you. Then what happens? The Bible condemns every species of dishonesty. And sabi ni Ellen G. White, half spoken has full power. So yung 50% ko hindi masasabi. I just end there. Amen? May the Lord bless you. Amen.
We have some questions. Or we can entertain questions right now. Any questions?
Sir, practically, what is the... practically, Pastor, what is the ideal woman as a theologian student or as a pastor someday?
Thank you. So tingin ko iba yung tanong na as a pastor kaysa as just a Christian. First, I would like to encourage you to open Facebook and like the page Clear Messages. There are many issues in relationship. Sino nakapanood dito ng Clear Messages? Oh, okay, thank you. So those who have not been acquainted with Clear Messages, we have coming 13 series of Hope Channel. Hindi pa naipapalabas, but it all talks about relationship. Coming series. But practically, there are things that we need to consider. Siguro as a pastor, so you cannot hear this on Clear Messages. As a pastor, yeah. Ano yung ideal woman as a pastor? First, a woman who would dare to separate with you should you leave the ministry. Isang babae na hihiwalayan ka kapag umalis ka sa pagpapasko. Kasi, I think a ministerial wife is a calling. She is called to be a ministerial wife. If you cease to be a pastor, what is her work? She was called to be a ministerial wife. When you leave the ministerial work, she's left alone with her own ministry. But I. One that would really encourage you to go And when you don't feel to preach, she would. Amen? There are times that you wouldn't feel to preach, she would. Amen? I don't say that you must find a woman even more mature than you are, but if you can't find one, don't be insecure. I have a 5 years older than myself wife. And you know, men are immature 5 years than his own age. And women are 5 years more mature than their own age. So how can just you imagine? We are 5 years older than almost like 15 years maturity gap. Amen? I don't think so. Ayoko naman magpatalo. But what I'm practically saying, the success of Pastor Edgar Bryan to lead him behind what? Behind it. The success of Pastor Edgar Bryan Solentino is not his own ability. It was the calling of my wife to the ministry that made Pastor Bryan, Pastor Bryan. Whatever I am today, majority of it was the influence of my beloved wife. But if you choose unwisely over choosing a wife, then you already have a script. Pray for my wife. Every midweek, pray for my wife. Pray for my wife. Pray for my wife. Pray for my wife. Pagdating sa workers meeting, pray for my wife. Sa mga band, pray for my wife. Then you have to memorize already your prayer request right now. There are many pastors who have not survived in the ministry, not because they are not good, but because of the wrong choice of wife. So first, one that would really carry you to the ministry. One who is a minister herself. Amen? Amen. One who will be a minister herself. Sabi, anong pattern pa so? At the LNG wife. Diba? Kung gusto niya ng pattern, tingnan niyo si LNG wife. Tingnan niyo kung paano niya sinundan si James White. She's not even a pastor. Amen? She's not even a pastor. She's not even elected in the church board. Diba? Was not even elected in the church board or any executive committee. But she was very effective in her prophetic office. Amen? So, second, yun, siguro halos lahat nandun na, no? Matindi, no? Talagang ministerial talaga. But there are maraming dito na ministerial wife talaga to. Minister in the future talaga to. But you must be very careful, I think, in the choice of this. Kasi marami dyan nagpo-volunteer. Marami dyan nagpo-volunteer. But you must be free from all this volunteer work. You must be free. You must observe from afar. Observe in the critical times. Tignan nyo yung critical times. Pag nagka-problema, tignan nyo kung paano niya i-handle yung situation. So as much as possible, kunin nyo siya for voice of youth, whatever, tignan nyo kung paano niya i-handle yung situation. Okay, tingnan mo din kung paano niya i-handle yung situation, baka ikaw na. Sabay ka din. You're expecting a better wife while you yourself is not better, di ba? So I think you have to see her in times of crisis. Because there are many, many crises in the district. Amen? Ahead of you. But you have to, from afar, kasi baka makasakit ka, nagbigay ka na ng intention mo. Yung, nagsisisi ako, I was very much about sad. When I gave a little intention to a lady, I was about to court during that time, but I saw a lady really, really 5 times better than what I was about to court. Sabi nung, patuloy mo siya dito, malay mo, ligawang ka niya. Tapos sabi ko naman, malay mo nga. I mean, those kind of intention, I should not have said because it was not really very ethical. If you don't have the intention na ligawang, papangasawa siya, don't give any intention. You will just hurt the lady. Lalo na kayo mga pastro. Naku, akala nila yung mga pahaging-haging nyo ngayon, yun na yun. Okay? Okay? So I think that is second. Observe her in her development of character, especially in times of trouble. Third. Ang nakikita ko quality na para talaga sa wife. I don't think it's the singing. Like, Pastor, she must be a singer. Okay, bumili ka na lang ng karaoke. Pastor, dapat marunong magluto. Bumili ka na lang ng rice cooker. Pastor, dapat magaling maglaba. Abay, bumili ka ng washing machine. You don't need you know, akala natin, ito dapat. There are many ideas. But I would say, first, she must love God supremely than you are. She must love God supremely than you. Minsan kasi mas mahal ka niya kasi sa Diyos. Kaya pag sinabi mo, na tayo mag-midwig, hindi na rin. Sasabihin niya, uy, tumahimik ka, bakit hindi mag-midwig tayo? And she would always push you to go to the district, to work for the Lord, amen? Because there are times that we are really discouraged, amen? And then, third, yung hindi nakikinig sa chismis. Balanced emotion. Let me give, final for that now. I think six things that she must be very mature. If she is not this, while in friendship, teach her. Pagka natutunan niya lahat to, then court her. Kasi sabi ni Ivan, Pasko, paano yan? Wala akong makita yung quality na gusto ko. Sabi ko, ikaw ang EY leader, mag-train ka. Ikaw ang master guy, mag-train ka. Pero huwag mong nililigawan. Pag na-train at nakita mo doon sa sampunin na train, meron talaga umakating sa the best talaga siya. Iba talaga siya. Ligawan. Pero nang ginawa ni Ivan, she trained and then when she found Donna to be the best, then niligawan niya. Kasi ang hirap mga kapatid, maghahanap ka, ito wala talaga eh. Eh kung ano, i-train mo na. But don't have any relationship, okay? Do it from afar. Okay, first, emotional stability. Because the first policy in emotion is this, yung magnification. Pag may problema ma, minamagnify niya. Konti problema na, minamagnify na. You have to be very aware of this because this is a big problem in the district. Second, jumping into conclusion. So jumping rope, okay lang, pero jumping into conclusion, mahirap. Jumping into conclusion. When somebody said something, then this woman already jumps into conclusion without any investigation. You have to be very aware. Yung asawa ko, kahit anong chismis mo, ang gano'ng titingin na siya. Meron na siya. Nakakasar mo. Okay, so jumping into conclusion. When a woman jumps into conclusion right away, that is not a, ano, mahirap siya maging ministerial wife. She must always balance. Even somebody says this, she doesn't right away believe. Then this is a good perspective. Amen? Third, emotional reasoning. She does not reason out of emotion. Bakit mo ginawa? Wala lang. Bakit ka nagalit sa akin? Wala. Doesn't make sense. Yung ayaw na ayaw ko sa ating pakurot, pakalo-palo. Nahilag mga babae ang murot, mamalo. Nabi-discourage ka agad ako. Okay? Isa pa. He must not read minds. Mind reading is not a good emotion. Diba? Bakit ka nagalit? Kasi inisip ko ganito ka. Oh, inisip mo lang, ganun lang ginawa mo. You have to be very aware of this. No mind reading. You cannot read minds. You have to qualify. What did you say? Did you mean this? Did you mean that? Ah, okay. Now I understand. Rather than just thinking about something and then emotional na siya kasi meron na siyang inisip na ganun pa. Okay? And, ano ba? Notification, jumping to conclusion, emotional listening, mind reading, and any more. Maraming taong gusto sabihin about yan. But you must take a woman who is emotionally controlled, not controlled by emotion. When you cannot master your emotion will master you. So, kumuha ka ng babae na, hindi ko naman sinabi, very phlegmatic, walang pakialam, pero pag sinabi ko may problema district, wala lang siyang pakialam. Kasi pag lahat yung pinakailaman niya, may chismis siya, mamamatay una ang asawa mo bago ka mag-retire. So, one that when you tell her the problem, she, baka naman ganito. Okay? So, this will solve your problem. Rather than a very emotional, sinabi niya, ano? Sinabi niyo? Pero makikialam na sa problema. I don't think that's a good idea. Okay? So, thank you so much. Meron pa? Okay.
Question.
I think that.
Pastor, this question will come from a selfie. It may be a little bit selfish because right now I am 36 years and
years old.
I don't know how many old, I don't know the age of my friends right now. We were talking about courtship, and also right now in the ministry or in college. we have to be careful and take time. Considering my age right now.
Yes, you have to consider your age.
What is the right thing to do? You know, when I ask if you could help with my, it's like something that I can understand. Honestly speaking, I'm really struggling with decision making right now. So I find this to be something that is benefiting me right now. So talking about courtship, right now, what is the best thing to do? Because it's like 36, 37, 40, and by the time I look back, everything is like, this guy is too old, we can't do anything with him.
Okay, let's talk about value. Men getting old, the value rises. Women getting old, the value goes down. But I don't want to degrade women, pero mataas ng mataas ang presyo pag lalaki, di ba? So when you get married at 30, 35, oh, this is a good, ano, your qualities are good, your maturity. Pero pag women kasi, meron physical lang yan. Tagal ng patagal, medyo physically, hindi masyadong very advantage. Pero sa lalaki, I think it, with men, if you get old and getting old, your value raise up. So don't have to worry about whether women will think about you like this. No, I don't think so. But we should not be very in a hurry about this kind of relationship. But situations vary. I mean, situations vary. So I counsel all these situations. Wrong information leads to wrong decision. So I think you are the best person to know your situation. You just have to really seek counsel with people and then tell them all the information you need to tell. Because I cannot tell that this age, that age, I don't think there is an ideal age. I'm not an ideologist. I'm more of an evidence person. Give me the evidence, I give you what to do. But to be very ideal, this is the ideal, this is, I don't think so. I'm not very ideal. I'm very skeptic on ideologies like this. Because many times when I apply this ideology to my situation, it even make me worse. So I think you can decide on that, you pray about it, you seek God, and then seek counsel, and the Lord will tell you what to do. Even if it's best for you to have your sweetheart right now, or sustain a little. I mean, keep it until it so desires. Okay? Thank you so much. Meron pa ba? Yes, another question? Alam ko, so if you have any question, maybe you can just ask me over Facebook and maybe you can help. Or if you need counsel, I can also maybe counsel by phone. But we will be praying for each other, for your success. Gusto ko makita kayo lahat ng very successful pastor in the district. Amen?
Amen.
Lord bless you.
After this, we will have our mentoring and counseling. You can also talk to Pastor Brian, our professor, Pastor